The Mulligan River is a dry desert river for 99% of the time. It rises up on the Northern Territory Queensland border, then it flows down through properties that are owned by Bush Heritage Australia like Cravens Peak and Etherbooka, and in a wet year it'll actually join up with the Georgina system down at Eyre Creek. Now what happens then is that up to 8 species of fish will basically go mad and colonise this usually dry river. And so in a really big year like this, after this big 2010 flood, we'll be really interested to see what goes up there. One species comes from as far away as South Australia, we think. If we work out what's actually going on in the river over a period of years, it's not only going to be useful with regard to managing the river, but it'll also be highly, educational with regard to how fish survive in Australian arid zone and semi-arid systems more generally.
What's really exceptional about this flooding event is that not only is the rain fallen in the catchments, it's fallen across the broader landscape through the dune fields and the ranges. Most of the clay pans, the ephemeral wetlands and the water remote river systems are now full of water. This landscape operates on a boom-bust cycle, and we're almost certain that this sort of flooding and rainfall will induce a real increase in the vegetation and the native animal numbers. And it's certainly going to be a fascinating next few months as we watch the desert come to life on these two bush heritage properties. Thank you.